Kevin Brady was telling me why corporate tax rates shouldn't be delayed for another year. Here why.
As the Senate delays the corporate tax cuts till 2019, the House plan starts them in 2018. How do you feel about that?
Sooner rather than later is the answer. We had this debate in the House. We just think the sooner we can become competitive, the better, especially look, our international competitors, they are not standing around while we're talking about and now acting on tax reform. So I think, you know, focusing on that 20% rate, trying to get it in place as soon as we can. I think the sooner we do it, the more competitive we become.
All right, with us now, former U.S. Small Business Administrator Hector Barreto. Hector, very good to have you back.
Thanks, Neil.
Do you think that it makes a difference whether it's 2018 or 2019?
It does for those 30 million small businesses. You know, they want to have some certainty so they can do their planning. And they're very interested in their bottom lines. You know, this discussion gets talked a lot about what's in it for the big guys. I'm interested in what's in it for the small guys. Those guys, any money that they have to their bottom line goes right back into their business. So we think it's critically important that this be effective next year for sure.
All right, so this talk where the president all of a sudden opened up the possibility of a higher rate than 20%, maybe 22%, maybe to pay for other things, what do you make of that?
Well, look, they're going to have to go to conference and they're going to have to figure out the differences between the Senate bill and the House bill. We weren't totally satisfied that there was enough for those pass-through businesses. So we're going to be keeping a keen eye on how it proceeds through the conference. But the president says he wants it done this year. He wants a Christmas present for these American small businessmen and women. So do we.
You know, Edgar, one of the things I heard from a lot of the 1% crowd, very angry that their rates won't change. At least in the Senate plan, they go down 1%, but you can't write off state local taxes. So for a lot of them, they're going to pay a lot more. Is seeing how they can become a pass-through concern to take advantage of that rate. And it wouldn't be the first time some wily types have tried to come up with ways to pay less in taxes. Do you think that could happen? And do you think many will seize on the opportunity to make it happen?
Well, look, there's always a chance for that to happen, and smart people always find ways to, you know, get around some of these things, and they have been for a long time. Some of the things that folks on Wall Street have been doing and not taking it as income and getting taxed as capital gains. But let me tell you, there's an opportunity cost here, Neil, and that is, if Hispanic businesses were growing as fast as all other businesses, they would add double what they're adding right now to the U.S. economy, $1.38 trillion. We just came out with a report last week. So there are big stakes, especially for the small businesses, which are the engine of America.
All right. Hector, good seeing you again. Thank you very much, Hector.